The Federal and Northern Territory governments will impose tough new alcohol restrictions in Alice Springs in an attempt to combat the town's spiralling crime wave. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese caved into pressure and flew into the Red Centre today.
They say a week is a long time in politics. For Team Albo, so is a day.
Albanese's going to places where rivers are overflowing and having a look and shaking hands and that. Come up here, mate, because the rivers of grog are overflowing.
In the wake of surging crime, yesterday no visit was locked in. Today the PM and his entourage filled a plane for a hastily arranged flight to the Red Centre, where the latest police data paints an alarming picture.
These are complex problems and they require a full solution.
In the past year, assaults are up 43%. Domestic violence has surged by 53%. Alcohol-related assaults are up 54%. Commercial break-ins and property damage have increased by 55 and 59% respectively.
Just another woman getting bashed in this town.
The sharp rise coming after the Northern Territory government repealed laws.
It's just got to stop.
Limiting the sale of alcohol in Indigenous communities.
They rolled this legislation back and they've allowed the alcohol to flow in town camps.
It's been increased since the bringing down of the liquor restrictions.
Some Indigenous elders have had enough.
It's been building, building, building.
We don't need symbols though, we need action.
A sentiment echoed by other locals.
This place is totally out of control. The violence on the streets is out of control.
The police commissioner says
the jails are full.
And even if they weren't,
you cannot arrest your way out of these social problems.
Albo's short stay aimed at finding a federal solution.
We've agreed to establish a Central Australian regional controller.
We will now have takeaway alcohol-free days on Monday and Tuesday. On the remaining days, from 3 o'clock to 7 p.m. only for takeaway alcohol.
There needs to be real mass investments into the Northern Territory.
A territory in a state of crisis. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.